What up YouTube, it is your boy All About The Sneakerz back with another unboxing and review video for you guys. Now as you can tell from the thumbnail as well as the title of the video, that is correct guys, we're unboxing the WMNS Air Jordan 1 Low SE Limelight. Now guys, this sneaker just popped up sort of out of nowhere, kind of like mids tend to do on a regular. I had no idea this shoe was coming. Comment below, let me know if you guys knew this shoe was dropping and if you went after this shoe or not. Now I do know a lot of guys typically do not go after women's shoes, but then again, some do. Me personally, I copped this for the personal keep. I thought it was a dope shoe. I don't get all into the gender specific type of shoes. Some shoes you could tell are really for women, but then again, some are unisex, which is why Nike tends to put a size conversion on the kicks, because a lot of consumers are gonna cop regardless whether it's labeled men's or labeled women's. However guys, if you're new to the channel or not, make sure you smash that like, subscribe and share button, and make sure you hit that notification bell so you can stay up to date on future release videos. Now with no further ado, let's go ahead and jump right into it. Alright, so as you guys can see here, I do have the shipping box in hand. This came directly from Nike, as we do have the Just Do It tape on there. However, I already have this one opened up. The anticipation, it wears on your boy. So I had to go ahead and pop it open guys, just waiting to get these videos up. I don't want these boxes to pile up, as I've mentioned in a few recent videos, so I'm just busting some of these boxes open versus cutting them open on camera, just to put that out there. However, let's go ahead and get this one open and get the shoe box out. Voila, and there we have it guys, the shoe box, an all white shoe box since this is a women's release. And we get that golden Jumpman right there on top of the lid, smack dab in the center. On the bottom of the box we get our typical Nike branding, but in gold as well. And on one side of the box we get that golden 23 with our size sticker, and the size sticker reads WMNS Air Jordan 1 Low SE. The colorway is Summit White Limelight. This is a women's size 11.5, which converts to a men's size 10. Personal size for me and Air Jordans. And the suggested retail value is $100 US. All right, so with this being an SE, I'm a little bit surprised that this shoe was only $100, because guys, this shoe has some very, very nice quality. However, let's go ahead and see what we have under the lid. Flipping the lid up, as you can see, we do have our typical flip lid on the box. We do get a lot number right there on the inside of the lid. We get our standard white tissue paper with the golden 23s all over it. And let's go ahead and get the shoe out. And there you have it guys, the WMNS Air Jordan 1 Low SE Limelight. A very, very clean sneaker in my opinion. Had to get this one for the personal cop. It is dope. Now this shoe did tend to sit out on Nike's website for some time guys, so it wasn't that hard of a cop, thankfully. However, let's go ahead and do a quick 360 on the shoe. So like I mentioned guys, this shoe did sit out on the website for some time. I debated and debated and debated all day long, and I finally pulled the trigger, which I'm glad I did, because this shoe has some of the best Air Jordan 1 quality for the year, not gonna cap. I can't even stress it enough. I mean, it's so good that I'm gonna say this shoe so far has the best leather quality on an Air Jordan 1 shoe this year guys, hands down. Also have the Air Jordan 1 High OG Light Red Fusion. However, I did not get the video up for that shoe. I may still do that video. But I do have that shoe guys, and it is very, very good leather on that as well. Could have been a little bit better, but it is good leather. It's some of the best, I would say the best Air Jordan 1 leather this year until this shoe dropped, which is crazy. However, let's go ahead and go over this shoe a little in depth. Starting with our outsole, we do get this Limelight rubber outsole that leads up to our white midsole. Moving on up to the upper, we do get Limelight leather going around our toe cap, as well as these other accents that do give it the Chicago color blocking. And that is some nice tumble leather guys. It's not just a texture leather, it is actually tumbled leather, and it is extremely soft. This is not the typical Air Jordan 1 Low that we have been seeing, especially on men's pairs. For some reason they went all out on this one for the women. And I'll show you, this leather here is really pushy. It does wrinkle a little bit. I don't really like to wrinkle my leather, so I'm not gonna push it attention to the extent that it does, but that does go all the way up here to the top. As you can see, the wrinkles forming. Very, very nice soft leather, very dope. Same goes for the swoosh, this rear heel area, as well as on up to our eye stay. Now here on this mid panel, as well as on our toe box, we do get this ballistic style mesh, something like we would feel on an Air Jordan 11, except this one's a little bit looser. As far as the stitching goes, as you can see, there's like some gappy kind of diamond shaped holes. However, this isn't canvas or anything like that. It is like a ballistic mesh. Now, I'm not a material expert, so I could be saying that wrong, but that's exactly what it feels like. It's something like you would feel on an Air Jordan 11. Comment below and let me know what you guys think about that material on the Air Jordan 1. Would you prefer it be OG or traditional with either leather or suede and that's it? Or do you not mind them switching it up and putting some different materials on the shoe? This one personally for me gives it a premium feel, and it also looks very breathable, which works for me. But again, comment below and let me know what you guys think about that. However, that is all I have for the lateral side of the shoe. Moving along onto the medial side of the shoe, we get an identical look as we got on the lateral side. Onto the top of the shoe, as you can see, we do have white on our midsole. We also have that limelight leather going around our toe cap, that ballistic style mesh here on our toe box extending all the way up to the tongue. We get those limelight flat laces in place, and on that little lace loop we do get a white stitch 23, and on up to the top of the tongue we do get a limelight stitch Jumpman. Little hard to see, he kind of blends in, but it's there, guys. Pretty dope. Onto the back of the shoes, you can see we get that white around our midsole going up to that leather and limelight, and we get that stitch white Air Jordan Wing logo right there on the heel. Very nice. Love how the shoe looks from the back. Onto the interior of the shoe, we get a limelight mesh sock liner as well as a limelight insole with the white painted Jumpman. We also get a cardboard shoe tree in place and our size tag in there on the back of the tongue with limelight on the back of the tongue in mesh. Another difference with this shoe, since it's an SE, you do get some padding in here, so it's really plush and pushy on the back of the tongue. Very nice. And last but not least, onto our outsole, as you can see, we do get a solid limelight outsole. Pretty clean. Now, as far as this shoe goes, I've never seen a colorway like this on an Air Jordan 1. This is very nice. I have seen some green, but this green is a little bit different since it's limelight. It's not just lime, it's not just neon. Sort of has a lime sort of pastel look to it. It's a little bit different. Gives me like a really light, young green bean look, like not the right one. However, guys, comment below and let me know what you think about this shoe, if you went after this or not, or if you will be going after this. Again, it is out there on Nike's site still to this day, I do believe, but sizes are starting to disappear, so you wanna act fast if you do wanna get this shoe in your possession. Now, again, guys, I can't stress enough how buttery the leather is on this shoe. I'm saying this has the best leather on an Air Jordan 1 this year, 2021, hands down, in my opinion. Take my word for it or leave it, whatever. But I do want to point out something about this shoe that stands out to me, because I'm pretty much an observer when it comes to shoes. I look at the fine details and things like that. And on this shoe in particular, made me feel even better when I looked at this shoe in person. And you may need to go check out some of my other Air Jordan 1 low and mid reviews to maybe get a better understanding about what I'm about to discuss. All right, guys, so when it comes to the women and kids pairs on Air Jordan 1 lows and mids, they do tend to cut the shoe and leave these accents just cut instead of tucked like they do on men's pairs. You may not have noticed that, but on the men's pairs they will cut this area and tuck it under then stitch it, as to where here you can see it is just cut straight across, just like we'll get on a men's pair of high OGs, but they tend to do it on the women's and kid lows and mids as well. Nike, do you have an explanation for that? I sure hope so, because it's not a good look when you guys tuck that leather or pleather or whatever it is on the men's pairs, on the mids and the lows. I think that's one thing that make people not like them as much. I mean, I can't speak for everyone, but it is noticeable if you really stop and look at it. Now, if the shoe is just walking past quickly or whatever, you're probably not gonna notice that. But if you look at it close, you will see that that leather is tucked, but it looks so much better when you just get this cut, distressed looking sort of leather going around these accents like we get here on our swoosh as well. On every accent is that way on the women's and kids pairs on the Air Jordan 1 low and mids, guys. So again, that's another thing that made me want this shoe. I just wanted to point that out because a lot of people do not know that. They don't take the time to look at those fine details, but I'm telling you, if you got a pair of men's mids or lows, go look at them right now and you'll know what I'm talking about. Or if you have a kids or a women's, go look at it and you'll see that difference. It looks so much better this way, guys. Just wanted to point that out once again. However, again, if you're new to the channel or if you're not, make sure you smash that like, subscribe, and share button, and make sure you hit that notification bell so you can stay up to date on future release videos. Now, when you get a chance, guys, go ahead and head over to IG and follow me at All About The Sneakerz, spelled exactly like it is here on the channel, with a Z on the end instead of an S. Trying to get my IG page up a little bit, guys, with the followers, so I really appreciate if you guys would go do that. Share it with your friends, whatever. I'd really appreciate it. However, thanks as always for tuning in. That is all I have for you guys on this episode. Until the next episode, keep keeping it all about the sneakers. Once again, it is your boy, All About The Sneakerz, signing off. Until the next episode, I will catch you guys later. Salute, I'm out.